I think he did. He had one of the best voices in rock and roll. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to A View from the Stage. I am Rob, and this is my lovely girlfriend and her dog, Boo. Aww. This is Stephanie.
Hi.
And what we're going to do today is we're going to listen to some more Allison Chains. We're going to be checking out Down in a Hole. I think that there's no explanation necessary for us to listen to this song.
Okay.
So, without further ado, let's go ahead and put the headphones on here. And 3, 2, 1, play. This is a terrific song.
It's pretty.
This out right here. Oh, that guy's voice. Jeez.
Down in a hole. off this beat. I love his voice. Love, 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 love his voice.
Mm-hmm.
I like the song.
But?
I mean, I like the song, right? If I'm going through a bad time, I'm sure this is a great song to listen to.
Well.
Right? Is that when you listen to the song?
So this song is about addiction.
Well, the lyrics... It's down a hole. I mean, it's not a very good thing. I'm like, you could be down a hole about a variety of things.
But he says, I want you to be inside me. And it's a man singing that.
I don't know.
Inside me.
Oh, right. Okay. Woo! See, I don't know much about this, so... Okay. Well, Jesus.
Yeah.
All right. Nay, I'm not going to listen to this song.
No?
No, I mean, like, you know, I can't relate, obviously.
Well, I mean, you don't have to relate to be able to think, man, that sucks for him.
It does suck. It sucks for anyone who's going through this.
I think that it's amazing that he lived from this album, which was in 1993.
Mm-hmm.
He lived until 2002. 9 more years of being an addict.
Oh, gosh. Yeah. That's gonna be rough.
Yeah.
Can't get out of that, too.
So, yeah, exactly. I think that Layne Staley, it's a shame. It's an absolute shame because I think he did. He had one of the best voices in rock and roll. Like, there's no way around
it. So they started in 93 or 92?
No, they started as a band in 1988 or 87.
Well, they had decent my years. I mean, it still sucks, but...
Well, they broke up in 1994, 95.
And got back together.
Nope.
Oh.
They got back together in like 2003 after Layne died.
So Alice in Chains is still technically a group, not the same original people though.
Yes.
Okay.
Jerry Cantrell is the through line for the band, the guitar player.
Mm.
He's the through line. Alice was his idea. And.
So, you know. And what does Alice in Chains mean?
I don't know.
Sorry, I'm asking you some tough questions.
Yeah, it's I don't necessarily.
It could just be a random band name they came up with, right? That's how most band names came up with.
Yeah. I mean, it looks really cool on a flyer.
Yeah, it does.
And that's yeah, a lot of the, I mean, a lot of the
well,
bands.
The name just seems kind
of
cool.
Well, a lot of the bands back then, they thought about would it look really cool on a flyer. Mother Love Bone.
Yeah, like, what does that mean?
Pearl Jam.
Yeah, I don't know.
Soundgarden.
Yeah.
You know, all those things look super cool on a flyer, especially when you're from Seattle.
Yeah.
The Melvins.
The Melvins.
Yeah, think about the Melvins.
No, I'm sorry. That doesn't sound cool at all. The Melvins?
Yep.
It sounds kind of boring. Kind of plain, Jane.
Definitely not boring. So anyway, what do you guys think? Do you think that... What's your favorite Alice in Chains song that that has a message. I think pretty much every song has a message by Alice in Chains, but I'm really interested to see what song is your favorite song that has a message. Leave it down in the comments if you have one. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and also click that bell for notifications. That way you're always informed whenever we put out a video. That's really cool. Anything to add?
No, not really. It's a great song.
Cool. Be well.